Welcome to RPA. In this video, we'll discuss about how to create a custom connector in detail. So if you want to learn about Microsoft Power Automate, please follow my complete Power Automate playlist so that you will be able to understand from scratch. Coming down to this topic where we are going to cover how to create a custom connector in Microsoft Power Automate from scratch. To create a custom connector, we must describe the API we want to create it or to connect it so that connector understands the API operations and data structures. Here, we'll build how we can create a custom connector. So for those who don't have the accounts, probably they have to create it. make.powerautomate.com account, and from there they can use this functionality. To build a custom connectors, simply we have to go to the custom connectors from the data sections and click on create blank custom connector. Here we also have different options like create from Azure services, OpenAPI file, import an OpenAPI from URL, Postman collection. So these all I will cover in further part of video, but this video is totally target for creating custom connectors. Click on blank connectors, add the name. So here we are just providing the name as custom connector. Click on continue and we have this options available. Now here, when we are clicking on the create options, we have to update general details. So these general details are descriptions which we can provide it. So here I'm just giving demo custom connector. After that, I can background color. If you want to add, you can add it. Otherwise, we can keep it blank. Even we can upload the connector details from the download sections. Here, maybe I will add this. Not this. We'll add this as a custom connector. And after that, we have to provide the host name. So if we don't have the host name or cognitive informations, we can keep the general fields because this must be a supplied. Otherwise, we won't be able to proceed further. So when we are talking about specifications and authentications, generally we have to give the forward slash and after that, move it to the security. In security options, we have four options like no authentications, basic authentications, API key. So let me explain you all this. No authentications, we are not giving any authentications to this custom connector. So it without doing any username and password, probably people will connect it. Next is basic authentications, which contains username and password, which we have. After that, API key. So for API key, we'll need parameter label, name, and the locations, which is query or header. And finally, OAuth2 authentications, which we can get it for the client ID, client secret, authorization URL, token URL, refresh URL. These all informations will be required. In the definitions field, we have different options. So in definitions tab, the left hand display any actions or triggers which is available, that is logic, apps, and Power Automate. Next is we have the reference and their policies. And there are no triggers in the connector we can have to learn from the different fields. After that, we have general options here where we can add different informations in this field. So let's say I want to add the general options of actions where we can provide summary, descriptions, and operation ID. If we are selecting for triggers, so probably in triggers we have different other details, but as of now we don't want to keep it functional, so we can keep it here. After that, we are jumping into the code sections. So in code sections, we have different code format which we can use it. If we have available code, probably we can upload those as well. And then we will test our custom connector and publish it. So here we want to add some request. So let's say if you want to add some request as a part of API request, so that is also possible to add it. As a part of request, we have get, delete, post, put, and these are the HTTP methods, URL, headers, and body. So when we'll cover the Postman collections URL, that time I will cover this in detail. And once we are adding these methods, probably we have to add some response method as well. When we are adding as a response, in the response fields, we can add key body output and the validations criteria. And if everything is fine, then probably we can proceed it further for the testing phase. And then we can click on create connector and our connector will be created successfully. Here we have not defined much fields. That's the reason we are getting an error. But these are the steps how we can create a custom connectors under Microsoft Power Automate. That's all from this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful. Don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.